This is the OTB Television Network, a service of Capital District Off-Track Betting.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's edition of Horses and Courses. 14 races to bring you as we gear up for the holiday festival of stakes action from around the country. This week's program, they're going to start north of the border at Woodbine, named after one of the finest distaffers of the last 35 years, owned by Frank Stronach, who pushed spectacular bid, that is Glorious Song, to his toughest race of his 1980 undefeated season. At the end of the day, the wagering, Norkey, the 7-5 favorite.
They're off in the Glorious Song. Spring like a cobra, springs right to the front of the outside. But now coming on to that one's inside, Ida Bambina, along with Zensational Bunny. And Zensational Bunny comes on closest to the rail to lead them out of the chute. Spring like a cobra's on the outside. In between horses, Ida Bambina. Henry's Island in fourth position and 2.5 lengths off of Zensational Bunny. Shanna Gary is down toward the rail, then Zuby Zuby Zoo, and Nor K trails this field. Only 4 lengths off the lead, though. That lead is held by Zensational Bunny. Her opening quarter was 23 flat. They head to the 3/8 pole. Zensational Bunny hounded by Ida Bambina. Spring like a cobra is out there 3 wide. Riding the rail is Shanna Gary, who'll need running room. Henry's Island called on for more run by Wilson in the run to the quarter pole. Nor K still has 4 to come. And they're coming over to the top of the stretch in the Glorious Song. Down on the inside, Zensational Bunny. Getting a great trip there with Shanna Gary. Angles out, let's see what she's got. Zensational Bunny, Shanna Gary. Far outside for Henry's Island as they come to the last 16th. Zensational Bunny was sensational this afternoon. Under a hand ride to win the Glorious Song to Norke, who closed late to finish second. Henry's Island third, Shanna Gary fourth.
Sensational Bunny, who was the 2-1 morning line favorite, went off at 8-5 off of the career debut, makes every pole a winning one, now 2-2 in her career, wins by just under 4 lengths for Mark Cassie and Pat Husband. She returns $5.20. Norkay, who was the 5-2 morning line second choice off of the career debut, ends up being the 7-5 favorite, can do no better than second, running from well back early. Henry's Island, nearly 18-1 under Emma Jane Wilson, finishes third in Saturday's Glorious Song. Turning our attention to Delta Downs, ladies and gentlemen, for their annual huge day of racing. 4 stakes races to bring you, 3 of which were contested at the 2-turn mile. Up first, the Delta Mile.
And they're off in the Delta Mile at Delta Downs. A good break for all. Coming away fast was Allsvid on the inside, but moving up is Uncaptured going right to the lead. Red Hot Rush now tugging his way forward, and now he's in front as they exit the chute. It's Red Hot Rush. The speedster has the lead. Grand Contenders placed along the inside, and moving up to third is Nate's Mineshaft. They're about 2.5 lengths off the pace setting. Red Hot Rush early. Less than a lap to go. It's Allsvid on the inside. Then comes Do No Harm, and back from there you'll find Decisive Moment. Troilus is another 2 lengths behind that group after the quarter win in 22.03. Blazing Fractions once again as they go around that first turn. It's about 6 lengths back to the back pair. That's headed up by Uncaptured, who is second last, must be 15 lengths from the front. And now he trails as Agent Dinozzo goes by. Half mile here in 45.16. Red Hot Rush still on the lead. Grand Contender is the closest pursuer there, racing in second. It's 4 lengths back to Nate's Mineshaft. He's now running side by side with Allsvid, and then comes Do No Harm. It's another 4 or 5 lengths back to Troilus, and then on the outside, starting to gain here is Agent Dinozzo, but he's still got about 8 lengths to come, and running behind him is Uncaptured getting underway, as dropping completely out now is Decisive Moment. Three quarters at 110.45, and Grand Contender has taken over the lead. Gerard Malanson goes to work. It's a scramble to catch up to him. It's only a furlong to go, and they're into the stretch. Grand Contender up by 7. Agent Donoso trying to get to him. On the outside, it's Uncaptured, but Grand Contender just keeps on going at 10-1. He'll win the Delta Mile. It was very close for a second between Agent Donoso and Uncaptured, and then a long ways back to Do No Harm in fourth.
New track record, ladies and gentlemen, for Grand Contender, who set off the early pace, then took over when wanting under Gerard Malanson. They scored the 10-1 victory for Maggie Moss and Tommy Amos, returning $23.60. This was a $20,000 claim at Saratoga 15 months ago, winning the third race in a row, first-time stakes for the winner. Agent Donoso, by a few shekels, second choice in the wagering at 2-1, finishes second, a nose in front of the 2-1 favorite, Uncaptured. Up next, two-year-old fillies, the $500,000 Delta Princess.
And they're off in the Delta Downs Princess, and everybody came away well. Zip On is showing speed right out of the gate. Bana moves up right beside that one, and behind Rivals, it's Misbehavior. Down on the inside, it's Teppan, a very close fourth as they step onto the main track. Settling back in the field is Concave, well off the rail, and behind that one is Appreciating. And now trailing early on is Synapse, about 8 lengths from the front with 1 lap to go. Zip On and Robbie Alvarado have the lead, but here comes the challenge from Bana early to the outside. They went a quarter in 22 and 94 one-hundredths. They're well bunched going to the back stretch. Down along the inside, Teppan has a ground-saving spot racing in third. Misbehavior advances from fourth. Length and a half from there, and you'll find Concave and Appreciating running right together. Then a length and a half back to the trailer, who is Synapse onto the back stretch. The half mile went in 47 and 50 one-hundredths. They're racing up the back stretch now with Zip On still showing the way. Bana is breathing down her neck and getting a little bit closer. Misbehavior's in a striking position on the outside third. Teppan is trapped behind Rivals. Moving up the inside is Synapse, starting to get closer now. Those front five within 2 lengths. Then comes Concave, who'll need to do a lot better as they're into the turn and coming for home. Bana now accelerates and went 3/4 at 112.57. Bana is taking off under Rosie Napravnik. She has it by a length, but here comes Teppan. Teppan's starting to rally now as Zip On is given out. Misbehavior's not giving enough. Here's the final furlong. Bana is set down. Teppan to the outside is coming after her. A 1/16 of a mile ago. It is Bana. It is Teppan. And Teppan gets the lead late. And Teppan wins the Delta Downs Princess. Bana was second. Third went to Concave. And fourth was Synapse.
Teppan scores the victory, drawing the inside, going the mile as fourth choice in the wagering, ladies and gentlemen. We had 4 runners between 5-2 and 7-2 in Saturday's Delta Downs Princess. But Miguel Mena going out for Mark Cassie. They're aboard the winner, scoring by a little bit more than a length, returning $9 even. Previously favored in all 3 starts, broke the maiden in the second career start, most recently third at Churchill Downs in the Rags to Riches Stakes, but adds the $500,000 Delta Downs Princess, the grade 3 to the resume. Bonan, who we saw dead heat in the opening day, Skylarville at Saratoga, more recently disqualified at Delta Downs at 1-10, comes back as the 5-2 favorite and finishes second with Rosie Napravnik in the saddle for the first time. And coming out of the Breeders' Cup, the horse who just stumbled over the fallen horse in the Breeders' Cup, Concave, beaten better than 70 lengths, finishes third under Mario Gutierrez. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, more action from Delta Downs and the fairgrounds gets underway.
Funding your Capital OTB bet account is as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1, easy money. Clearly the fastest and easiest method of depositing funds into your account. Make deposits or withdrawals in just minutes. 2, Green Dot Money Pack gives you instant access to your funds. Green Dot Money Packs are available at thousands of retailers nationwide. And 3, MasterCard Visa. Simply click on the link from the funding page, enter your account information, and fund your account. CapitalOTBBet.com. Log on today.
Hey, race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook and get in the game. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, fantastic food and drinks, an amazing Vegas-style atmosphere with seating for nearly 900 of your closest friends. Conveniently located at 711 Central Avenue, right off Exit 5 of I-90 in Albany, the Clubhouse Racebook is the better choice.
Welcome back to Horses and Courses, continuing on with our stakes action from Delta Downs. Up next, the $1 million Delta Downs jackpot. Keep your eye on the number two post.
And they're off in the $1 million Delta Downs jackpot, and it was not a good start for Coastline, who trails the field early. Mighty Brown came away fast and goes to the lead. Rise Up is on the outside. To the inside, it's Roman Unbridled, and behind rivals, you'll find Rum Point and Casiguapo. Big Bazinga's way on the outside. The back group early on is Why Are You Awesome, followed here by Flat Gone. Then comes Rank Has Privileges, and Coastline is the trailer about 10 lengths from the front as Rise Up now takes the lead with one lap to go. It's Gerard Melanson and Rise Up leading affairs. Mighty Brown is right behind the leader, and then comes Rum Point, who's between rivals. On the outside, that's Casiguapo. Tucked in at the rail is Roman Unbridled. Then comes Big Bazinga within about four lengths of the lead after the quarter went in 22.82. It's Why Are You Awesome back in the field. Then Coastline now out of the trailer spot. Next to him out there is Rank Has Privileges. And now the trailer is Flat Gone. The half mile in 46 and 31 hundredths. Rise Up trying to nurse it on the lead. To the outside, it's Casiguapo getting a little bit closer. Big Bazinga's in with a chance about three off the rail. Mighty Brown is tucked in down on the inside. Backing up a bit is Rum Point. Here comes Rank Has Privileges and Coastline. They're both coming after the leaders after three quarters. Went in 111.94. Rise Up looks to have plenty left. Gerard Melanson is sitting chilly, but here comes Rank Has Privileges. Mighty Brown is under a drive on the inside. Then Casiguapo. Big Bazinga has checked out. Coastline is back from there, but it's Rise Up who has the lead. Rise Up went three quarters, 111.94. He's coming to the 16th pole. It's Gerard Melanson. And Rise Up, air up the tires, gas up the tank. He's on the road to the Derby. It's Rise Up in the $1 million Delta Downs jackpot. Casiguapo was second, third went to Rank Has Privileges, and fourth was Roman Unbridled.
And Coastline, who was the 8-5 favorite, breaking from the number two post position with that camera shot. Very, very easy to see the horrible stumbling at the start. Rushed up to get into contention, but as often is the case, that early energy used up, just too much to overcome, but not too much to overcome. Rise Up, ladies and gentlemen, who makes every poll a winning one for the second choice in the wagering, ridden by Gerard Melanson. Tommy Amos sends out the winner, returning $6.20, raising the career record to four wins in six starts. Casiapo, who was a key component in a $3,000 plus trifecta in the Hopeful Stakes, finishes second here in the Delta Downs jackpot. Rank Has Its Privileges, finishes third. Coastline, with that horrible start, going for three in a row at 8-5, finishes eighth. Continuing on with the 1 mile stakes action at Delta Downs, the Treasure Chest.
And they're off in the Treasure Chest at Delta Downs. Fast start on the outside by Livy McKenzie. Showing speed is Juliet Deer, moves into second. Then comes Pretty Knot in the white cap to the inside. Angling to the outside here a bit is Touch Magic. She's trying to find clear sailing. Three lengths back then to Class Included. As second last coming past the grandstand is Forgotten People, about eight lengths from the lead, and the trailer early is a running pop. Up front, that's Pretty Knot. This 80-1 long shot leads affairs into the first turn. Just off her flank is Livy McKenzie, and now Touch Magic. Wants to be forwardly placed, she advances three wide. They went a quarter mile in 23 and 11 one-hundredths. Tucked in behind the leaders is Juliet Deer, then comes Class Included. It's another three lengths into Forgotten People, and still a running pop is at the back, as we only have six lengths front to back onto the back stretch. They have a half mile to race. The opening half went in 47.85. We have a three-prong battle for the lead. It's Pretty Knot, this long shot down on the inside, then Livy McKenzie between horses. On the outside, that is Touch Magic. She's dropping back a bit. Class Included looks to rally past her, and still bottled up is Juliet Deer. As they approach the far turn, Forgotten People's getting underway from the back of the pack, as now trailing is a running pop. They're midway around the far turn, and we have a new leader. It's Class Included. Three quarters win in 112.60, and Class Included takes off. Now she leads Livy McKenzie by a length and a half, now two. Juliet Deer is three wide in third. Touch Magic is fourth, and then comes Pretty Knot, but they're into the stretch, and Class Included at the 16th pole is absolutely full of run. Class Included and Rosie Napravnik to win the treasure chest by about six lengths on the line. Livy McKenzie was second. Third went to Juliet Deer, and fourth was Touch Magic.
Class Included, making the first start since May 3rd in the La Trienne Stakes at Churchill Downs, scores by half a dozen for Rosie the Praverick as the second choice in the wagering. They return $5 even. First time at Delta Downs. First stakes win since winning the Ballerina. Not the Ballerina at Saratoga, the Ballerina at Hastings Park. In 22 career starts, Class Included 11 victories, 7 second choices. Livy McKenzie finishes second, and at better than 60-1, Juliet Deer finishes third. Touch Magic, the 6-5 favorite, who was runner-up in the 2012 Delta Princess, finishes fourth at 6-5. Friday afternoon, they kicked off this year's Fairgrounds meet, and on Saturday afternoon, we had the first stakes race, the first turf race. The stakes race to Mr. Sulu Stakes.
Rail at 25 feet. Turf yielding. And the gate. And they're off in the Mr. Sulu Stakes. String King, Tiger Run, flashing that speed. Kissimmee Kyle, here's Midnight Heist. Coming up on the outside to 5-4-2 with Tiger Run, with one circuit to go. So it's Tiger Run taken on early by Midnight Heist, who's keen under Richard Aramia. As they enter the first turn, it's Tiger Run, the leader from Midnight Heist. String King, third there for James Graham as they go to the back of the course. Outside String King's quarters is Kissimmee Kyle right there too, with Patrick a saving ground in fifth. It's a length and a half back to Michael's Gabriel, followed by Sunwave, and dropping back to last is late running City Soldier. They race up the back stretch. It's Tiger Run, Midnight Heist racing out deep on the course. Tiger Run by a length and a half. Midnight Heist running second by five. Kissimmee Kyle together still with String King, and they have four furlongs to go. Patrick Kisses, 10 lengths off the leader, Tiger Run, a break of three to Sunwave, Sadie Soldier up one spot. Michael's Gabriel has been relegated to last. Half mile in 50 and 3/5 seconds as they go to the far side of the Fairgrounds course. Tiger Run's made every yard so far. Midnight Heist under pressure. Tiger on the outside, gaining ground now is String King and Kissimmee Kyle right there. As they close in on Tiger Run, as they come past the quarter pole. It's Tiger Run, the target for String King at the top of the straight. String King has taken the lead now from Tiger Run. Kissimmee Kyle went under pressure. Sadie Soldier charging down the center of the course. Sunwave and Patrick is after that. They're deep in the final furlong now. It's String King, Tiger Run, tenacious toward the inside. It's String King. String King and James Graham. It's String King at 1-5 in the Mr. Sulu. Tiger Run finished second. Farther back was Sadie Soldier with Sunwave. Kissimmee Kyle finished fifth.
And the turf season gets underway with the rail out at 25 feet, a yielding turf course as they kicked off Friday afternoon on a racetrack that started out sloppy. You see with the rails up at the Fairgrounds how narrow the turf course is. But String King didn't matter at 3-10 on the board on the yielding turf course, going out for trainer Arnold Charles Smith. They score the victory, returning $2.60 under James Graham. Tiger Run finishes second at better than 45-1, with Sadie Soldier, second choice in the wagering, finishing third in the Mr. Sulu Stakes. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, Churchill Downs and Hollywood Park.
Listen to what people are saying about the Clubhouse Racebook.
It's really nice. It's really modern, open, bright, and there's definitely a lot more machines where you can make your wagers. And I like the fact that it's open anywhere I look, I can see football if I want to, or any of the tracks. Then I can also see the people that I've seen for many years. You feel comfortable, the staff is great, it makes you feel comfortable. It's a nice place to spend an afternoon on your weekend.
Each morning on the OTB TV network, you get the very best in horse racing programming. Weekdays begin with the Handicappers Report, where professional handicappers share their selections and analysis of the day's racing. Followed by Racing Across America, a daily conversation with racing personalities from around the country. Saturdays include Down the Stretch, where Mark Cassano speaks with the biggest names in racing. And Sunday mornings, it's Loose on the Lead, where Steve Bick and I offer news and a unique lineup of weekly guests. All here on the OTB TV network.
Turning our attention to Churchill Downs, ladies and gentlemen, for a turf stakes race. And just a quick note, as you hear Mark Johnson's call, and the favorite changed in the race, and the turf condition a little bit different. When the wagering was finished by a few shekels, Colport, the favorite at 5-2.
They're in the gate. And they're off. In the River City Handicap, and Sky Ring came in on the field there and gave one or two a little bit of a bump. Very unbalanced coming out of the gate was Cole Port, whose rider really was unbalanced for a stride or two, and Potomac River was also taken right out of his stride early. So a dramatic start, and Villandry, the favourite, dropped right out the back of the field. So they come up past us with a circuit to go in the River City Handicap, and it is Sky Ring on the outside of Old Army as they go into the turn. Set the Sail is racing in third, and in fourth is Grand Arch, followed then on the inside by Olympic Thunder, who's racing in fifth, and then last year's winner Keep Up in sixth. Colport to the Hedge is in seventh, followed around the outside by Daddy Knows Best. It was 24 seconds flat for the opening quarter mile on the soft turf. Potomac River is last but one, and Villandry, held up by Julien Leperoux, is racing some 9 lengths off the leader, who is Old Army, who clicked off the half in 48-2. Through halfway in the 36th running of the River City Handicap, it is Old Army who has the lead. Sky Ring in second, 2 lengths away. Set the Sail is in third. Grand Arch will go to the turn, racing in fourth position. Losing ground now is Olympic Thunder against the inside hedge, as making ground now around the outside. Here comes Potomac River. Villandry is still last. Keep Up is last but two, as they now swing the corner. A quarter of a mile to go. Old Army taken on by Sky Ring. Set the Sail and Potomac River running huge to the outside. Next is Grand Arch as they race inside the final furlong and a half. Villandry now begins to pick up down the outside together with Daddy Knows Best. They're inside the final furlong. Potomac River trying to spring the shock is out in front by 2 lengths and going away for Juan Vargas and racing up towards the line. A shock winner of the River City Handicap. It was Potomac River who wins. Potomac River and a bunch for the places there, with Grand Arch to the inside of Set the Sail, Daddy Knows Best, and to the outside, Villandry.
And on a good turf course at Churchill Downs, the longest shot on the board under Juan Vargas, Potomac River. And folks, how rarely will you ever see this watching races every single day? Here's a horse, 45-1, mugged at the start by Sky Ring from the outside, and is a comfortable, easy winner, returning $93.40 after an awful, awful beginning. How about these odds for Potomac River, who has won 5 races in his brief career? 45-1, 9-1, 7-1, 37-1, 12-1. This horse's average winning mutual is about $46, and the number 13 saddle cloth pays off at a tremendous $93.40. The exacta comes back $1,141. The trifecta comes back better than $9,500 for Potomac River. Awful start, tremendous finish at a huge price. Set the Sail finishes second. Grand Arch finishes third. Valandry, who was the barely second choice in the wagering, finishes fourth. And Colport, who was 0-for-2 lifetime at Churchill Downs, exiting the American Turf and the 2011 Breeders' Cup Juvenile, finishes seventh as the 5-2 favorite in the River City. Couple stakes races to bring you from Hollywood Park. Up first, 2-year-olds in the Real Quiet Stakes.
They're off. Electric Eddie and Karma King. Karma King smart into the first turn. Green Mask and Life is a Joy. Here's Life is a Joy up into second. Then comes Better Bet, followed by Beach Hut, Mr. Splash, and the early trailer is Tamarindo. Karma King to the backstretch leads by a length and a half to Life is a Joy in second. Green Mask is a tugging third, and he's about 2.5 or 3 from the front. Better Bet and Electric Eddie, fourth and fifth with 5 lengths to make up. Beach Hut has 6 lengths to close. Then it's 3.5 back to the two trailers, Tamarando and Mr. Splash, as they run up the backstretch in the eighth. Real Quiet Stakes, 2-year-olds with 5 furlongs to run, and Karma King is the leader. Karma King, 2 lengths in front of Life is a Joy in second. Green Mask continues to travel third. He's about 3 off the lead. Here's Green Mask to tug Kentasormo up into a joint second now, and he's after Karma King. Green Mask takes second, a length and a half from the front. Better Bet will be 3 wide. Beach Hut and Electric Eddie are 3 from the front. Here's Electric Eddie to move through at the rail and take third. Tamarando has 6 lengths to make up. Mr. Splash has dropped out last midway on the far turn. Karma King continues to lead. Green Mask has every chance to outfinish him. They're a quarter of a mile from home. The whip is out on Beach Hut. Electric Eddie has a run. He needs a way through. Life is a Joy. Tamarando closing in the center of the racetrack, and you better take a look at Tamarando. Karma King, Green Mask, and an on-rushing Tamarando. And Tamarando has run right by to take over the lead. Karma King, Green Mask, and Electric Eddie battle for minor awards as Tamarando runs away and wins the Real Quiet. Tamarando scored by 2.75 over Electric Eddie. Karma King was third, and Green Mask finished fourth.
Tamarando making the 7th career start. Scores the victory by better than 3 lengths with new pilot Rafael Bejarano aboard. This recent winner, the Del Mar Futurity, was second choice in the wagering, returning $7.40 for this offspring of Bertrando being sent out by Jerry Hollendorfer. Electric Eddie finishes second with Karma King third. Green Mask coming off of the career debut and the 6-5 favorite in the Real Quiet finishes off the board fourth. And just as a note, as we go to the next stakes race on Sunday afternoon at Hollywood Park, know this isn't a rerun, but the Saddlecloth, the trainer, the owner, and the jockey, very familiar, Sundays on Trust Handicap.
They're off. Cyclometer and Campari break well. These two are quickest in two stride to the outside, and maybe Tuesday. Luckerack is close up as well. Then just behind the leaders, it's Spirit Rules, followed by Star Spangled Heat, and the early trailer is Mobilized. Rousing Sermon is in the early mix as well. It is Campari to head up the main track, up the back stretch, and he's a half length in front. Now less than that in front of Cyclometer. Campari leads by a head. Cyclometer is second, 3/4 of a length. Spirit Rules and Rousing Sermon are trying for the same spot. That could get very tight going into the far turn. Spirit Rules kicks on between horses. Rousing Sermon is fourth, and he's less than a length from the front. Luckerack is fifth. He's got 2.5 to come. Maybe Tuesday is 5 from the front. Star Spangled Heat has 8 to make up, and Mobilized is 9 lengths behind. 3 furlongs to run in the 30th on Trust Handicap. California Breds to the quarter pole, and Cyclometer puts ahead in front. Rousing Sermon goes with him. Spirit Rules all in at the rail and a half length back. Luckerack is 2.5 off the lead. Campari tails off 5 from the front. Rousing Sermon and Cyclometer to the final furlong. They're about to be joined by Luckerack in the center. Rousing Sermon half ahead. Cyclometer battles back from the inside. Now it's down to these two, and it's going to be close. Rousing Sermon, Cyclometer, Mobilized closes late. Rousing Sermon gets to the lead. Rousing Sermon, yes! The 30th on Trust Handicap goes to Rousing Sermon over Cyclometer. Mobilized flew late to get third over Spirit Rules in fourth.
Rousing Sermon, second choice in the wagering with Rafael Bejarano in the saddle. Jerry Hollendorfer, the trainer, the number 6 Saddlecloth once again, owned by Mr. and Mrs. Larry Williams, who also own Tamarando. They score the victory in the 29th running of the On Trust Handicap, returning $6.60. Cyclometer finishes second as the 8-5 favorite off of a allowance victory, getting a buyer triple speed figure under Mike Smith. They finish second. Mobilized finishes third in the On Trust. Take a quick break. When we come back, a handful from the Big A.
This is Steve Beck. Join me Tuesday through Saturday here on OTB TV for At the Races, my SiriusXM daily news magazine of the thoroughbred industry. Handicapping, interviews, analysis, everything you could want. 6 a.m. OTB TV.
Wagering at CapitalOTBBet.com is as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1, Capital Bet TV, the fastest and easiest online wagering experience where you can monitor 5 different tracks simultaneously. 2, Capital Bet Express. Its straightforward program layout and interactive handicapping information lets you build your wager quickly and efficiently. And 3, Capital Bet Pro, designed especially for the professional horse player. CapitalOTBBet.com. Log on today.
I'm Jeff Carl. Join me Saturdays and Sundays at 9 for the Handicappers Report. We'll handicap the top tracks across the country and help you prepare for the weekend in racing. That's the Handicappers Report. Weekends at 9, only here on the OTB TV network.
5 races to bring you from the Big A, 4 on Saturday and 1 on Wednesday. Wednesday afternoon, 3-year-old filly is going 6 furlongs in the Pearl City.
And they're off. Indian Splendor breaks on top. And Believe in Charlie sent through on the inside of Indian Splendor. And then it's Miss Mischief who's come out running third. And Uno Duo has come out running fourth. The early trailer is heiress of the crown. So it's Indian Splendor up for a short lead over Believe in Charlie. Those two together at the half-mile pole. The opening quarter, a lively 22 and 4/5 seconds. And then it's Miss Mischief running in third. Uno Duo kept out of harm's way in the clear on the far outside and four, still about 2 lengths from behind now. Joel Rosario wanting more from Uno Duo. The trailer is heirs of the crown as they come toward the top of the stretch. And it is Miss Mischief who turns for home with a narrow lead. Down toward the inside, Indian Splendor, and Uno Duo is struggling. Struggling mightily in the final furlong. Miss Mischief. Miss Mischief in front. Indian Splendor second. Uno Duo no better than third as they come down to the finish. Miss Mischief reports home by 5. Indian Splendor was second. Uno Duo checks in third at 1-5.
Miss Mischief adding blinkers, changing barn after 4 races in the Anthony Dutcho barn. They move over to Steve Asmussen. A convincing winner by 6 lengths is second choice in the wagering. Miss Mischief returns $7.80. Indian Splendor finishes second. And the 3-10 favorite, Uno Duo, finishes third in Wednesday's Pearl City. 4 stakes races in the Stallion Series to bring you from Saturday afternoon at the Big A. Up first, the Great White Way.
And the rough. Social Rebellion, Free Mugatu, Sal the Freud there. Lady Smart Aleck and At the Rail, Empire Dreams up the backstretch. And it's Lady Smart Aleck sprinting out to take the lead from Sal the Freud, second by 2. Free Mugatu third. And then it's Empire Dreams down on the inside and fourth. And the last of the 5 is Social Rebellion as Lady Smart Aleck takes him through an opening quarter mile, 23 1/5 seconds, up and on the pace, Sal the Freud, second by another 2.5. And then Free Mugato has Empire Dreams pinned down to the rail for the moment. Rod Ortiz trying to motivate Empire Dreams at this point, still about 3.5 from the front, but now getting closer, and will try to get through on the inside, but it's very tight there. Social Rebellion still the last of 5. Top of the stretch, 3 of them head-to-head for the lead here. It's Lady Smart Aleck, Sal the Freud is there, Free Mugatu, and now Empire Dreams has been switched to the outside for clear running into the final furlong. They're coming down to the final 16th of a mile, and Empire Dreams comes on now on the far outside. And Empire Dreams takes the lead 100 yards out and strides away. A 3-way photo for second among Sal the Freud, Lady Smart Aleck, and Free Mugatu.
Empire Dreams breaking from the rail at 4-5, going out for Tommy Albertrani and Irad Ortiz. West Point Thoroughbreds runner scores a convincing 1 3/4 length Victory returning $3.70. You know, I read Ortiz tried to save all the ground, tried to get through on the rail at the top of the stretch. That didn't work out. By the time they got to the eighth pole, Empire Dreams was in the four path. Second time LASIK, second time versus winners after being second in the recently run Bonnegard Stakes. Empire Dreams, winner of this year's Great White Way. Up next, two-year-old fillies in the Fifth Avenue.
And they're off. Miss Narcissist and Champagne Ruby. Hey Kiddo comes up from the inside. Up the backstretch. Miss Narcissist, the fastest out of there. Hey Kiddo comes up on her inside to run in second now. And then it's Sky Saratoga racing in third. And a well-held Champagne Ruby, who's fourth and on the outside. And then it's Sharifa running fifth down toward the rail. Missy Bay in between horses. Selenite forced to go four or five wide as they move for the far turn. Quarter up in 23 and 1/5 seconds. Hey Kiddo pokes ahead in front. Those two now in an all-out tussle rounding the far turn. Perched outside them, Sky Saratoga is poised in third. Sharifa just in behind the lead. And now fourth, Selenite continues a steady advance, but a wide advance it is. Then Champagne Ruby and Missy Bay, tight pack, top of the stretch. Hey Kiddo, Miss Narcissist, head-to-head. Sky Saratoga coming to them on the outside. Champagne Ruby cut loose. With one furlong to go here, it is Hey Kiddo and Miss Narcissist. Nip and tuck for the final 100 yards. Hey Kiddo, Miss Narcissist. Miss Narcissist is surging. Hey Kiddo fights right back. Photo finished that appeared to go to Miss Narcissist. Quite narrowly over Hey Kiddo, Champagne Ruby third.
Miss Narcissist going for three in a row at even money gets the job done, returning $4.10. That's three victories in a row after running fifth as a 3-2 favorite at Saratoga on August 8th. Hey Kiddo finishes second. Champagne Ruby, longest shot on the board, finishes third in the Fifth Avenue. Continuing with the Stallion Series, the Staten Island.
And they're off. Jitney and Myjopia. Myjopia shortly. Jitney down on the inside second. Keep Us Then runs in third early on here. Haldane is now fourth. Family of Roses, the gray far outside fifth. And Vicky's Dancer in a little bit of traffic there. Racing sixth on the inside of PJ Super Ego. Now seventh. Kelly Got Frosty also in tight. Second to last is She. And the last of them all is Match Made in Heaven. The leader down the back stretch is Myjopia. 23 and 4 was the opening quarter mile. Haldane's not far behind. Family of Roses makes a steady advance now to be third, right up with the pacemaker with a half mile remaining. Jitney on the fence and fourth. And then it's Keep Bustin' running in fifth. On PJ Super Ego on the far outside. Vicky's Dancer down toward the fence about five from the front now, and she comes off one path to try to get around Jitney. In behind that grouping, it's Kelly Got Frosty, but she'll have to take the overland route into the stretch. Still trailing the field is Match Made in Heaven, but she's in relative striking distance as they turn for home. Top of the stretch, Myjopia. Family of Roses there on the outside. Jitney has plenty of room to come through down toward the rail. Haldane is in the mix too. Coming up on the outside is Vicky's Dancer. Keep Bustin', Kelly Got Frosty way out there. PJ Super Ego, wild finish coming here. Family of Roses, and here's Vicky's Dancer. Those two nip and tuck down to the line, and it goes to Vicky's Dancer. Family of Roses second, followed by PJ Super Ego third.
Vicky's Dancer under Eddie Castro scores the neck victory as second choice in the wagering for Rudy Rodriguez. Returning $10.80. Two back, this was a $50,000 claim for Rudy Rodriguez. Scores the Stallion Series victory in the Staten Island. Family of Roses finishes second. PJ's Super Ego finishes third. Kelly Got Frosty drawing the rail as the 2-1 favorite finishes fourth in the Staten Island. And wrapping up the Stallion Series on Saturday afternoon at the Big A, seven furlongs, the Thunder Rumble.
And- and they're off. Uncle T7 missed the break. Comandante comes out running, and so too Read the Byline. And up from the inside comes Chapman. Up the backstretch, Read the Byline and Chapman go head-to-head for the lead. Comandante now back running in third. And then Sports Riders fourth and on the fence. A break of another three. Back to West Hills Giant, who settles into an easy beat. About 7 lengths from the lead now. Then farther back, it's Areno, Uncle T7, Anaflaxis, and last of all is Jax R. Wild. 23-1 was the opening quarter mile, and Chapman leads him into the far turn. Read the Byline, Comandante keeping pace on the outside third. Sports Riders fourth. Then a break of another two as West Hills Giant gets underway now and takes to the outside, lengthening his stride. A break of another three. Back to Uncle T7, followed by Areno, Anaflaxis, and Jax R. Wild. They're moving toward the top of the stretch. Comandante now coming up on the outside. And then Chapman braces for the challenge down toward the rail. West Hills Giant continues a prolonged rally on the far outside. Then down toward the rail at Sports Rider into the final furlong. Castellano says go with Comandante. Comandante out there length, and West Hills Giant still giving chases. They come down to the final 16th. Chapman down on the inside third, and Anaflaxis late in the game. On the wire, Comandante was in command at the end and won it by a length. West Hills Giant was second. It was close for third between Anaflaxis and Chapman.
Todd Pletcher sends out Comandante for the victory under Javier Castellano. They set off the pace early, then score by a length and a half, returning $9.30 as the third choice. In the wagering, West Hills Giant finishes second as the second choice. And the longest shot on the board at 33-1, Anaflaxis finishes third. Chapman, the 2-1 favorite, breaking from the rail off of a two other than victory, finishes fourth in the Thunder Rumble. That wraps up this week's edition of HNC, ladies and gentlemen. And the holiday weekend kicking off on Thanksgiving Thursday. Plenty of stakes action from around the country Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. We invite you to join us next time as we review them on Horses and Courses.